Hey everybody, Sword Aware, welcome back to the Legend of Dragoon. While we were on the Queen Fury and learning a little bit about some of the characters, this fam ship found us. So, it's time to explore again with our next dungeon. So we go from a Twister Glaive to a Glaive for Albert if we wish. What's the point of going from a Twister Glaive to a Glaive, honestly? I would think the Twister Glaive should be in the better weapon, should be told. The Beast Fang, which, in the Warrior Dress, which were relevant at approximately the end of the first disc and the beginning of the second disc. Stun Guard, whatever, and Magic Ego Bell. A voice of abnormal stats, but witchment. Actually, not a bad thing to get here, because bewitchment can happen here. You haven't seen it yet, and it is evil. Evil. Think confused, but instead, your always attack is, it's Berserk, essentially. Except you can't attack the enemy. So, it's bad news. Very, very bad news. I don't really need the Spirit Ring, do I? Nah. Spirit Ring kind of loses its effectiveness once you get the War God Sash. So, I'm not too worried about that. Bravery Amulet, eh, not a bad thing. Panic Guard, not a bad thing, but honestly, I think I'm pretty good here. And if we want to go back, we can go into the item shop here, and let's see what the item shop holds for us. Hopefully something good. Well, Dancing Rays and Trans Lights here. Now, if this isn't suggesting anything, I don't know what is. Trans Light and Dancing Ray are great items here. Now, the Dancing Ray would be great for attacking multiple enemies, but almost everything here is a dark base. So these items are great news. And let's see, is there any items I really don't need at this juncture? Moon Serenades at this point. I really don't need that many, but whatever. You don't want to get rid of Moon Serenades, you know, willy-nilly, because they are so valuable, just by virtue of what they are. Sachets, I mean, Sachet, I probably could just junk one and be okay with it. I know what they're supposed to do, I know what they're good for, but I'm not going to really worry about it. And, Sun Rhapsody, why not? I don't use Sun Rhapsodies too often. This gives me a little more space to work with. So, anyway, back on the ship. Now, by virtue of you seeing the red arrow, you're always, if you touch any enemy, you'll be attacked by him. So, it's like Helena in that sense, or Black Castle. Also, there's a mystical treasure chest here that has a combo. We'll do that later because I want to try that. But first thing we really need to do is explore the ship. And the first place to go is actually the captain's cabin. Which is not that, by the way. The captain's cabin is actually over here. But first, let's touch a will-o-wisp, get into a fight, and see what we got. Now, I do like this dungeon. I don't know why, but I just do. But it kind of is just it's a very small dungeon, relatively speaking, and the skeleton tried to pwn Shana and failed miserably. Thank you, 5%. So, the skeleton, as you saw, was the one who threw bones. Purely physical, he throws bones, doesn't do anything, just does damage. Damage him enough, he'll do a sword attack, does more damage. Will-o-wisps are very, very fast, very nimble, have low HP, and know how to use a burnout. So, don't be surprised if you'll be doubled up by the main time. It does happen. Also, Dart having a heat blade makes him kind of ineffective against those things. So you do want to be on the lookout for that. Now, because Shanna's a light type here, she conceivably could have a field day. But, well, we'll worry about that when we get to it. And my god, Kongo, why are you so slow? Please attack once! Please! There we go. And with the War God Sash, as you see, he gets he gets 50% more spear points. That is great for him. Absolutely great. because big limitation with Kongol's limited editions is he doesn't gain much SP. So getting the opportunity to turn to a Dragoon in two editions, pretty big help. So the world list, you can just see, is effing fast. Really effing fast here. So, you know what? Let's double up someone's speed here. Match that guy, maybe surpass him, and then just go to town. Like I said, Will-O-Wisp, I don't believe have anything more than like 160, 170 HP. They'll go down easily. Kongol can one-shot them. That's another way to put it. Kongol can one-shot them. So, that's the first fight. Probably the tamest of the fights here. Because skeletons are just sort of foot soldiers in a sense, and Will-O-Wisps really only become dangerous if they can get a burnout off. Captain, please open. The captain is not here, so... The Phantom Ship tells a little bit of a story here. Just a tad. Which, so you're basically sort of like watching... You're sort of like... acting in a play that's playing out around you. It's a nice touch. And there, right there, is an enemy you don't want to be near. Appropriately named Death. Death can do massive things to you. It has a scythe attack. Probably very painful. Very painful indeed. Can also cause fear, and because it's Death, it knows how to do instant death. Needless to say, you don't want to be around that guy. He's not particularly fast. I don't give a shit. I want him gone now. That guy stays for more than one turn. It could be my ass. Don't take any chances with Death. Of course, this was a lesson anybody learned if they ever played Castlevania. Don't fuck with Death. Because Death does heinous things to you. Including, but not limited to, summoning a bunch of size, basically being the bane of visiting the bane of everybody's existence, known as Stage 15 in the original Castlevania, stealing your powers and stuff in Symphony of the Night, etc., etc., etc. So, with that out of the way, the rest of this fight should be sort of a cakewalk, I hope. So, not too much drama there once you take out Death. And this door's not opening. You have to do this in order to sort of move on. I hate this. I hate this one room because it's so hard to navigate around the Will-O-Wisps, as crazy as it seems. I wasn't trying to get hit by one there. I just failed miserably. Anyway, I'll be back. Thanks to those Will-O-Wisps, these fights take forever. I guess there's one thing about it. I'm probably happy about the fact that this dungeon is actually very, very short. But if you don't go to the captain's cabin, you don't get to see this. As you see, the ghost crew is clearly suffering. Well, in order to be a ghost, you kind of have to, you know... So they're clearly fearing something horrible. Also, ghost crew A, they're kind of a glitch. So something terrible happened. And... needless to say, they died. That's why they're ghosts. Also, that weasel just went in there. And I'm finding my way to another fight. So congested these rooms are. So it makes it very easy to bump into these guys. Too easy. I'm so happy that Kongol can one-shot the Will-O-Wisps. But it's really dubious when you see Kongol freaking with a speed-up. He still would be slower than Shana. 30 times 2 is 60, Shana's 65. Maru's a 70. So, yeah, that's not good. Anyway, we saw the weird ghost thingy going here. That is a magician bogey, and has a weird top hat thing, likes to do that weird laugh and shit, and is busy harassing us by giving us her skeletons to work with. Well, I prefer skeletons over the, it's just ordinary skeletons. They're not anything extraordinary here. I prefer skeletons. You know why? They don't dodge like crazy and they don't move 18 times a second. They don't have Lina's speed. Thank you very much. So, thankfully, I know what I'm getting with these guys. These guys are pretty mediocre at best. They have about the same HP as Will-O-Wisps, truth be told. Maybe slightly more. And they go down to a dart, crush dance, and a Shana arrow. So, in other words, they go down pretty easy. And Shana is dodging everything, and thank you! Thank you, Material Shield! Because that would have done a lot of damage. Actually, if I had new Material Shield there, I'm pretty sure Shana would be dead. I'm pretty sure. And now, this guy's down. Interesting thing I didn't mention about the counters. If you get countered, and you have a chance to evade, you can actually evade the counter. You'll get blown back as if you got countered, but interestingly enough, you will have the chance to evade it. I had that happen in the Barrens last time. It was comical. Very comical. No, it's comical? This guy going down. Thank you for being punching bags. And that's the first encounter with the Magician Bogey. As you see, it's not a bad one. Unfortunately, you're going to meet more of them. So, on to the next room. And what do we got in door number two? Well, I see two more skeletons. I see a chest here. This can only mean one thing. A dick in a box, of course. Only this time, the Magician Bogey wants to fight. And the Magician Bogey is easily scary. Much scarier than the skeletons. Has more HP and can bewitch you, stun you, and otherwise be a complete nuisance. It also looks like a freaking pimp. It is a pimp. I'm calling it right now. I'm calling it the way I see it. That thing is a freaking pimp. P-I-M-P pimp. Got the cape, the top hat, and everything. That is... Okay, honestly, real talk, that is somewhat incredible. Anyway, let's get the minions out of the way. Because I don't like them. And one Magician Bogey is better than one Magician Bogey and two skeletons. And you see, he hits about as hard as a skeleton does, so... You know, his melee isn't impressive. It's his other bullshit that you gotta worry about. And worry about it, we will. First, Kongle does massive damage. Oh god, that's gonna hurt! Ouch! Son of a gun. I swear to god, Shana is a punching bag here only because dark light dynamic. I swear, I don't know if it's confirmed anywhere, but I do swear that if you have an elemental weakness, they attack you. Now, Magician Bogey does count as a minor enemy, so the Magic Stone Signet actually does work on him. And thank God for that, because if it didn't, we'd be in a world of hurt. Alright, you know what? Shana, you're guarding. Thank you, Magician Shield. Material Shield. And with that, I think... Okay, he's still going to the basic melee, so he's not in the yellow yet. When he gets the yellow, I'm going to be on the lookout. I'll probably put everybody on guard just to demonstrate what he can do. But trust me when I say this, you don't want to leave anything open. With this guy. Here it comes. The flowers. Shit. That's Bewitch. Bewitch works like this. As soon as Kongo goes, he'll attack himself, you, or Dart, or Shana. He'll never attack the enemy, though. How do you get rid of this? Two ways. You can turn into a Dragoon, do a Dragoon special, or you defeat the enemy that did it. So, I'll tank it this time around because I think I can. I don't think Carl was going to kill me. But let's just say I'm not very happy about that development. You see why I don't like it? Okay. Alright. Fine. Gloves off. Heaven, let your light shine down, and please bless this poor magician bogey by smiting him with the holiest of judgments. I didn't want to pull it out, but you gave me no choice, you son of a bitch. When he's in the yellow, he's probably more likely to do the stun attack. When he's in the red, well, you saw that. That is Bewitch. You don't like Bewitch. Bewitch is not your friend. Bewitch better belongs as the name of a movie than it actually does as a status ailment on someone. Although I think Bewitch would have been better if we were facing a succubus, but that's neither here nor there. So, two chests here. One is legit, 20 gold. One is not legit. Is it trying to say something? You know it's a magician bogey in there. We know this for a fact. And nothing we do is going to change that. So, let's just get ready for it. Because... this fight is going to suck. Not one, not two, but three magician bogeys now. And I would say attack them one at a time. Because attacking them all at the same time means you could be running into mass bewitchments and stuns, and you're not winning if that happens. You are not winning if that happens. So, we can soften up all of them. As long as we don't take him down to the yellow. And that's probably what I'm going to aim for here. Luckily, only Shana really needs the SP in order to trigger special. So it is an option. But I'm going to tell you what my plan is. Because 40 does come with plans, sometimes. The dancing ray I got, I'm using here. Also, Dart's Crush Dance got an upgrade! 85 points now. So, honestly, doing a dancing ray here is a big risk if everybody's in the blue, because it puts them all to yellow, and you know the drill. It doesn't end well for me. Also, stop moving so fast! Ah, damn. Alright. I'll attack this guy now. Go! Crash dance! I think it would be really cool if they weren't, you know, didn't have the monster faces, and they actually looked like actual pimps, maybe had like a bow tie or something. I thought that actually be a pretty cool touch. Anyway, you know what? I don't think you've actually seen this yet. I decided against the dancing light, so I think I'm just gonna go this route. So, Kongol, as you see, big man being held up by the same size wings that everybody else had. Now, his Dragoon attack only goes up to 4. Kind of unfortunate, but it is what it is. But can't deny the power of it. 482. Yikes. Yikes, indeed. Now get the hell out of here. I said get the hell out of here. Whatever. You son of a donkey. Alright. Remember what I said. Bewitch goes away when you take out the enemy that did the bewitching. How many HP you have? That's the stun, by the way. Alright. Congo, if you want to move some of this Millennium, that'd be great. I'm just saying. I think Shana's legitimately dead now. Not like I really care. I'll get her up. I'm not worried. You die now! 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 Fuck you. And right on cue, like I said. I'll worry about Shana later. The important thing to note here is I am legitimately pissed off right now, and I'm going to prove it by doing something I should have done a long time ago. That. This fight is deceptively a tricky fight, though. I will say that. It also helps that they move a lot faster than I remember.
Yes.
And they have more HP than I remember. I thought they had around like 700, but it sure didn't feel that way when I was dealing with them earlier. I think that's three. Dart, if you want to move now, that'd be great. Got him.
Yes. Go.
Peace. Also, if you're down, you don't get any experience from a battle. You come back though with one hit point. If you know that tickles your fancy, it probably doesn't. With that out of the way, time for me to get Shana up. Let's go to town again. Why are healers so freaking fragile? Man. Okay. With that in mind, I'll heal. I don't care. I'll milk it. Good thing I did that. Nah, Shana's up again. She's now the magical punching bag. And you know what? Fuck you. Fuck you, bogey. We're done here. Wow, he's got way more magical defense than I thought. Here we go again. Should be some Benny Hill music going to this shit. Oh, thank you for attacking yourself. That actually helps me out a little bit. Oh, fuck you! Now you're just fucking around me, game. End the charade. Now. You see why you might want those magical ego bells? Not bad for those guys. But, allow me to say it, I hate those guys, but mercifully you'll never see them again. But you do see this tormented spirit about the ghost captain. So now we gotta go back to the captain's cabin to go any further. But first, what is this here? Remember that chest in the beginning? 1679. So, if we go back to that chest in the very beginning, we'll actually get a chance to work on that and see what we can do. Because that chest actually does contain some pretty good items. I will have a, I'll try it, but I will have a listing of what you can actually get showing up via text at some point. Now, 1679, and there's three numbers. So, obviously, should we combine the numbers those ghosts were saying and put them here? Well, you have 10 attempts to do this. So, if you don't, you get in a fight with three skeletons. No big deal. 1679, huh? I got nothing up. I believe how it works is if you see three ellipses, you got something right. So, wow! What a dumb guess. I can't believe that actually worked.